Hello viewers and listeners, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about the roles of participants in a folk dance. A folk dance shows the life of people in a community or in a society. Different communities in Kenya have different folk dances. These folk dances are performed in groups or as solo. We have those folk dances that are meant for men. We have those dances that are meant for women. We have those dances that are meant for boys, meant for girls, meant for both boys and girls. We have those dances also that are meant for both men and women. One thing to take note about folk dances is the participants. Now, the participants, these are people that take part in folk dances. And this is what we are going to talk about. One of the participants of the folk dances is the soloist. Now, a soloist, this is a person who leads the rest in singing the melodies of a folk songs. Let's tackle the roles of this soloist. Now, number one role of the soloist is to pitch the singers so that they're able to sing without straining their voices. So the soloist is there to pitch the singers. The second role of the soloist is to introduce the participant of a folk dance to the audience. Number three role of a soloist is to cue singers on the change of melodies and to cue the participants on the change of body movements. So if they are dancing a certain body movement, it is the work of the soloist then to cue the participants on the change of body movements. The fourth role of a soloist is to address the audience. Now, one thing to take note on the performance of the folk dance is that the choral singers or the participants of the folk dance sing the same tune throughout the performance of the folk dance. This style is known as unison, whereby singers or performers sing the same tune throughout the performance. So it also applies to choral performance, whereby when we have all the singers singing the same tune without providing that harmonic support or without harmonizing the tune or the melody, then that is what we refer to as unison. So in folk dances, we sing in unison. There is no harmony of voices or of the melody. The second participant in folk dance is response group. We can call them the singers. Now, the singers or the response group provide an answer to the soloist during a performance. So when we have a soloist leading the performance, then we have the response group who are responsible in providing an answer to the soloist during a performance. The third participant of a folk dance is the instrumentalist. Now, instrumentalists are participants who are in charge of playing the instruments. These instruments accompany folk dances. So in my coming videos, I'm going to make a video concerning the roles of instruments in folk dances and in performances. The dancers. Now, the dancers, these are people that are responsible in making the dance movements, the dance formations. So to finish on, all participants in folk dances, including the soloists, the response group, the instrumentalists, and the dancers, have to make sure that they are working together to make a performance a successful performance. So kindly subscribe and put on that notification bell.